Hello students, welcome to the class on working with Microsoft Internet Explorer. The objective of this session are to study the Microsoft Internet Explorer. To study the concept of Internet Explorer, that is opening a web page, opening multiple browser windows, opening multiple tabs in a single browser windows and their management. Also to study the advantages and disadvantages of Microsoft Internet Explorer. Let's start with the introduction. So, what is Internet Explorer? Internet Explorer, formerly known as Microsoft Internet Explorer and Windows Internet Explorer, commonly abbreviated as IE or MSIE. It is a series of graphical web browsers developed by Microsoft and included as part of the Microsoft Windows line of operating systems starting in 1995. It was first released as part of the add-on package plus for Windows 95 that year. Later versions were available as free downloads or in service packs and included in the original equipment manufacturer, which we called OEM service. Releases of Windows 95 and later versions of Windows. Latest version of Internet Explorer, that is IE8, is used for the Windows XP and Windows Server 2003, while IE11 is used for Windows 7, Windows 8.1, Windows Server 2008 R2. The concept of Microsoft Internet Explorer are opening a web page, opening multiple browser windows, opening multiple tabs in a single browser windows and their management. So, let us start with the meaning and definition. So, opening a web page, before going to start with this, we must know what is a web page. A web page is a simple document displayable by a browser. Such document is written in the HTML language, which we look into more detail in other lecture. A web page can embed a variety of different types of resources, such as style information is nothing but controlling a page's look and feel. Script is nothing but which add interactivity to the page, and media is nothing but images, sounds and videos. All the web pages available on the web are reachable through a unique address. To access a page, just type its address in your browser address bar. A website is collections of linked web pages plus their associated resources that share a unique domain name. Each web page of a given website provides explicit links, most of the time in the form of clickable portion of text that allow the user to move from one page of the website to another. To access a website, type its domain name in your browser address bar, and browser will display the website's main web page or home page, casually referred as the home. Web page and website are especially easy to confuse when a website contains only a web page. Such a website is sometimes called a single page website. Web server. A web server is a computer hosting one or more websites. Hosting means that all the web pages and their supporting files are available on that computer. The web server will send any web page from the website it is hosting to any user's browser per user request. Don't confuse in between website and web server. For example, if you hear someone say, "My website is not responding," it actually means that the web server is not responding and therefore the website is not available. More importantly, since a web server can host multiple websites, the term web server is never used to designate a website as it could cause a great confusion. In our previous example, if we said my web server is not responding, it means that no websites on that web server are available. Search engines are a common source on confusion on the web. A search engine is a special kind of website that helps users find web pages from other websites. There are plenty out there: Google, Bing, Yahoo, and many more. Some are generic, some are specialized about certain topics. Use whichever you prefer. Many beginners on the web confuses in between search engines and browsers. Let's make it clear. A browser is a software that retrieves display web pages. A search engine is a website that helps people find web pages from other websites. The confusion arises because the first time someone launches a browser, the browser displays a search engine's homepage. This makes sense because obviously the first thing you want to do with a browser is to find a web page to display. Don't confuse the infrastructure, for example, the browser, with the service, which is nothing but the search engine. The distinction will help you quite a bit, but even some professional speak loosely. So don't feel anxious about it. Here is an instance of Firefox showing a Google search box as its default startup page. Web page is a web document that is suitable for the World Wide Web and the web browser. A web browser displays a web page on a monitor or mobile device. The web page is what displays, but the term also refers to a computer file, usually written in HTML or comparable markup language. Web browsers coordinate the various web resource elements for the written web page, such as style sheets, scripts, and images to present the web page. Typical web pages provide hypertext that includes a navigation bar or a sidebar menu to other web pages via hyperlinks, often referred to as links. On a network, a web browser can retrieve a web page from a remote web server. On a higher level, the web server may restrict access to only a private network, such as a corporate intranet, or it provides access to the World Wide Web. On a lower level, the web browser uses the hypertext transfer protocol, which we called HTTP, to make such requests. A static web page is delivered exactly as stored, as web content in the web server's file system, while a dynamic web page is generated by a web application that is driven by server-side software or client-side scripting. Dynamic website pages helps the browser, the client, to enhance the web page through user input to the server. Images of web page is shown here. Let's start with the steps to open a web page. So, click on Start, tap Internet Explorer, then tap the address bar. Type the web address as you type. Internet Explorer will suggest possible matches. Otherwise, tap Go. To refresh a web page, tap Refresh in the address bar. To stop a web page while it's loading, tap Stop in the address bar. Let's start with the opening of multiple browser windows. So before going to start with that, we must know what is a web browser. So a web browser, commonly referred to as a browser, is a software application for retrieving, presenting, and traversing information resources on the World Wide Web. An information resource is identified by a Uniform Resource Identifier, which we called URI, and may be a web page, image, video, or other piece of content. Hyperlinks present in resources enable users easily to navigate their browsers to related resources. Although browsers are primarily intended to use the World Wide Web, they can also be used to access information provided by web servers in private networks or files in file systems. The primary purpose of web browser is to bring information resources to the user by retrieval or fetching, allowing them to view information, that is display, rendering, and then access other information by navigation or following links. Now let's start with steps how to open multiple browser windows. So for opening a browser window, right click on the desired links using the right mouse button. A pop-up menu appears. Select Open Link in New Browser Window. This will launch a new web browser window which will access the desired link. While waiting for these new pages to download, return to your first web browser window to explore other links. The easiest way switch back to your other browser window is to use Alt and Tab. Hold down the Alt key, click on the tab just once. Now you can let go of the Alt key. Having multiple windows or tabs open in your web browser at the same time is an advanced trick that can help you get the most out of tech boomers. The most obvious way it can help is if you want to keep one of our tutorials open while you work on the website that the tutorials is for. Using multiple browser windows or tabs can let you do this without having to keep doubling back from one website to other. Whenever you want to read what the next step is in our tutorial, for apply it practically on the designated website. Most of the links from tech boomers to the websites of the services that we provide tutorial for open a new web browser window or tab when you click them. Now let's start with how to use multiple browser windows. Using multiple browser windows is similar to using multiple browser tabs, but it can allow you to have multiple websites not only open at the same time but also viewable on your screen at the same time. They take up a lot of space though, so you may need to resize your windows or even use multiple monitors if you want everything to display properly. The easiest way to use multiple browser windows is by finding a button or link that take you to a new website. Right clicking on the button with your mouse to bring up a menu and then left clicking open a new window. You can also open a new blank browser window by clicking file and then new window in your web browser's menu. Using your keyboard, holding control and then pressing N. From there, you can use a search engine to find something else that you want to be able to be doing at the same time as everything else, or if you know where it is, just type in its address in your browser's address bar. Now, to switch between two open browsers window, find the icon that represents your web browser at the bottom of your desktop screen. You will notice that it has overlapping squares on it representing how many windows you have opened. By moving your mouse over this icon, you should see thumbnail images of the entire browser windows that you have opened. Click the thumbnail that corresponds to the window you want to look at to display it. You can also quickly close an open browser window here by clicking the X in the top right corner. If you have your computer set up to use two monitors, you can even move one window onto the screen on your spare monitor. And that's a quick introduction to how you can use multiple windows or tabs with your web browser. Now let's start with opening a multiple tab in a single browser windows and their management. The interface design, a tabbed document interface, which we called TDI or tab, is a graphical control element that allows multiple documents or panels to be contained within a single window. Using tabs as a navigational widget for switching between sets of documents, it is an interface style most commonly associated with web browsers, web applications, text editors, and preferences pans. GUI tabs are modeled after traditional card tabs inserted in paper files or card indexes. In keeping with desktop metaphor, the name TDI implies similarity to the Microsoft Windows standards for multiple document interface, which is MDI, and single document interfaces, which is SDI. But TDI does not form part of the Microsoft Windows user interface guidelines, because the tabbed document interface holds many different documents logically under one window. It keeps the primary operating system interface free of the clutter that would be created by a large number of small child windows. Another advantage is that sets of related documents can be grouped within each of several windows. Tabbed web browsers often allow users to save their browsing sessions and return to it later. Manage windows and tabs. You can control the way windows and tabs look on your Chromebook screen. Open a window. To open a new Chrome window, click the Chrome icon on your shelf. If you already have a Windows open and want to open another one, press Ctrl plus N. Move or control windows. Maximize a windows. Click the Maximize button. To minimize a window, just click the Minimize button. View full screen. At the top of your keyboard, press the full screen key. This key also called as F4. Switch between windows. at the top of your keyboard, press the Windows switcher key. This key is also called as F5. Students, let's now focus our discussion towards the advantages of Microsoft Internet Explorer. It is very important to know that Internet Explorer is one of the most well-known internet browser in the world. It comes as pre-installed on many Windows computers. It is faster with Windows computers because it is integrated. Some websites can only be used with Internet Explorer. It is universal, and some applications are optimized for IE. Here are its advantages and disadvantages of Microsoft Internet Explorer. So let's start with the advantages. The first advantage of Microsoft Internet Explorer is it is available for free. It has reached all the nations with internet connectivity. It is also present by default with any versions of Windows operating system. Some sites can only be opened specifically for IE, and now Internet Explorer is still the most widely used browser worldwide. The Internet Explorer version 9 and above use of HTML5, which enhances browsing experience. This lets the user stream videos and audios, exempting any requirements of installing additional plugins. Internet Explorer, being one of the oldest and conventional web browser, supports a broad array of applications which some modern web browsers may not support. Internet Explorer aids in reopening the latest browsing sessions which the user might have accidentally closed. Some websites, particularly businesses' web page, can only be viewed properly with Internet Explorer because of its previous large market share. You have to know that there are various special features in Internet Explorer that can help the users in viewing sites, like the special accessibility setting where you can choose to ignore font colors, font styles, and font sizes. Particular web pages specifies for better viewing, or format web pages using a custom style sheet. Internet Explorer has several features regarding security, one of which is its zone-based protection framework, which groups websites according to specific conditions, applying certain limitations on every particular zone. It is very important to know that Internet Explorer can be set up with its group policy feature, in which the Windows Server domains implement different kinds of settings involving the user interface, such as disabling menu item and individual configuration options. With Internet Explorer, you still have the option of configuring your own policy setting. Internet Explorer has a peculiar cache of visited websites that can be found in your temporary internet files folder, giving you quicker access to previously visited pages and the ability to view them while offline. Internet Explorer supports specific frameworks like ActiveX and VB support, which are essential to applications that range from e-learning simulators to web-based accounting programs, which are important to many business websites. Let's see the list of disadvantages of the same. Everyone must know that Internet Explorer has no add-on support. it slows down with the newer versions such as IE7. It may be less secure than other browsers. It becomes buggy easy and it is targeted by the hackers. You have to know that the user may face an issue regarding the speed of Internet Explorer. It is considered slower than Google Chrome in some regions, and there are limited options for customization in Internet Explorer compared to Google Chrome and Mozilla Firefox. It is very important to know that Internet Explorer offers fewer add-ons, extensions, and plugins. Alternating various features of Internet Explorer through plugins and extensions are not that possible with Internet Explorer. There is no track filtering feature in Internet Explorer. You cannot import or store a customized list of blocked websites. Security implements on Internet Explorer still need to be improved, as it is a conventional web browser. Phishing attacks and scam organizers target Internet Explorer the most. Internet Explorer often fails to read the scripts in some particular CSS websites. The security system is not optimal. There is no tab feature, and speed in the open web quickly defeated by the other, especially in small bandwidth condition. Heavy when opening a new tab and start first. So these are nothing but the list of disadvantages of Microsoft Internet Explorer. So let's come to the conclusion. This version of Microsoft's browser brings the product into closer compliance with the web standards and adds a couple of interesting features. Aside from that and new internal changes, this first beta looks nearly identical to Internet Explorer 7. This is an early testing version meant for developers, so as you had expect, it's buggy. In addition, the new support for standards actually prevents some major sites from displaying correctly. Thank you.